What is up, guys? Patrick here, and this is just Patrick because Kundwani couldn't make it today. I have no idea what his reasons are because he hasn't called yet, but the show must go on. So today I will be going over my 1989 Honda Prelude, which just came back from the mechanics about 2 weeks ago. They ruined a whole bunch of stuff, but through the help of Google, I was able to find different wiring diagrams I needed to sort out the wiring connections that were ruined. And it also has a ton of vacuum lines, so I did get some diagrams for that and managed to get under the hood and rewire all that. But when I decided to now start the car and run it for a while, I noticed that it was overheating. So I thought that today I could make a video so that I can help somebody out there who has some overheating issues figure out why their car is overheating. So there might be a ton of issues with your car or with this car, but I will go over 4 reasons why your car might be overheating. And yeah, let's see how this goes if we're able to help somebody out there. So first things first, if you're dealing with a car that's overheating, you want to wait until the car has cooled down completely, and then you can carry out the following tests. The first thing we want to find out is if our cooling fans are working. So the cooling fans are found right behind the radiator, which is that big block in front of your car. That is where the water passes and the heat is able to escape from the engine through the fans blowing cool air over your radiator. So to check your cooling fans, you want to go inside your car and start the car. And once you've started the car, you want to put the AC on very high and then make sure that the AC button has been pressed so that your AC system is actually running through the AC compressor. And if they come on, then you know that your fans are okay and that's not your cooling problem. Second thing we want to check is if our coolant level is at the right place. So go under your hood and find the radiator cap. Normally the radiator cap will have some sort of caution sign on it, so a big bright yellow or maybe red sticker will be on it, and you can be able to open this. But remember, again, only open this when your engine is cold. The warning actually says it on the cap. So open the cap and check if your coolant level is all the way to the top of the radiator. Now, some cars will also have a coolant reservoir. So like on this 2004 Toyota RAV4 that we're looking at, you can go to the side where the coolant reservoir is. You'll be able to see it. It's labeled coolant. You'll be able to check that as well. The levels will tell you whether it's full or not, and just make sure that that is full. If both of those are full, put the caps back and make sure that they're closed tightly, and then you will know that that is not the problem with your cooling system. Note that it's probably not enough just to top up the coolant system, but you want to find out why exactly your coolant went low. So you might want to look for leaks under the car when you park your car, but if you're running the AC, it will drop a little bit of water, but that water won't be hot. So you want to check and make sure that there are no leaks when you park your car. And also you want to look out for a sweet smell in your exhaust. If your car is burning coolant, it will give off this sweet smell, and that's probably going to be a more expensive repair because that's either a blown head gasket or your cylinder head is cracked or something like that. So the third thing that we're looking at is our thermostat, which was actually the issue in my car. And what your thermostat is, it's actually a valve that opens and closes to allow and block water from flowing through to your radiator. So mine was blocked, and it's a simple thing to remove. You want to find out where your thermostat is, and in my car, it's at the end of the top radiator hose in the thermostat housing, and there's just 2 bolts there that I had to remove, and finally got the thermostat out. So this is what the thermostat looks like, and this is just how the valve works. On one end, it blocks the water, and then once it gets to operating temperature, which for mine is 82 degrees Celsius, it's supposed to open and allow water to flow through to the radiator, and then your fans can cool that water down. So a simple check for the thermostat to see if it's working is to put it in boiling water, and I put mine in boiling water and it was able to open slightly, but after adjusting it a little bit, I was able to get it to open all the way, and the thermostat is now fine. So if your thermostat is working, then put it back, make sure that you change the gasket that was on it, make sure that thing is closed tight, and that should work just fine. The fourth and final thing we're looking at is if there is a blockage in the radiator. Sometimes there's dirt and bugs that get stuck in the radiator, and if air is not able to flow cleanly through your radiator, then you will have an overheating problem. So you want to make sure that your radiator is clean. You can have this cleaned whether at a car wash or something. When you have that high pressure hose, you can just spray through the radiator and that should clear everything up. If that doesn't help you out, then you probably have much bigger issue, but these were like the basic things that you could look for. So thank you so much for watching, guys. Subscribe to the YouTube channel if you haven't already. Next week we will definitely have a different car to review and have this vlog experience and just take you guys around to just check out more about the motorsports and car community in Zambia. Thank you so much for everybody who made it to the end of this video, and until the next week, I will see you guys. Take care and have fun.